I'm Greg Atkinson. I'm here at Monsoon on Capitol Hill with Sophie Banh. And Sophie, I understand you're going to make a salad with some pomelo and jicama. Tell me about what you're doing here.
Okay, I will cut the jicama.
Great, I'll get this out of your way.
Okay.
Now, jicama is a vegetable or a fruit that I usually associate with Southwest food, but you use it a lot in Vietnamese cooking as well?
Yes, we do. Jicama is very popular, or maybe they can grow on the countryside. So when we cut it off and we need to peel the skin.
Yes.
Okay. Either you can use the peeler or the knife.
Well, you're pretty handy with a knife.
Yeah.
I can actually hear the crunchiness of it.
It's crunchy and juicy too. So not only crunchy, but very juicy. Texture is very flavorful. So I'm going to julienne this.
Nice. So you have the jicama and the pomelo, and then there's a dressing, I understand.
Okay, so now I'm mixing up the dressing. We use a half cup of cumin soy or any kind of soy, light soy, cumin, or any kind of soy, whatever you have.
So half cup of soy.
Half cup of soy. And you mix with half cup of distilled vinegar or white vinegar.
May I?
Yeah.
Great. So half cup of soy and a half cup of vinegar.
Okay. And I'm chopping the onion, like a diced onion.
Okay.
So I can use like a one tablespoon, mix it in the soy.
Looks like a pretty fine chop.
Yeah. Okay, so I use this one.
Yeah.
Okay. And also I mix it up the olive oil, the extra olive oil, around one tablespoon.
So just a little bit of oil.
Yeah, like a little bit of oil. I would say one tablespoon, mix it up. We use the mixed green, mixed herb, any kind of green, either the green leaf or butter lettuce, any kind of green, whatever you have.
So this looks like mosh, frise or endive.
Right.
And some radicchio.
Yeah.
Nice.
I mix it kind of, the frise make it nice light green color. They go with a dark green, a little bit of red color.
And also the contrast in flavor, because the mosh is very mild and the frise is very bitter.
Yeah.
Okay.
And also jicama make it crunchy and juicy into the salad.
Nice.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, so this is just enough for one serving, huh?
Yeah, one serving.
And there's
and half a cup of jicama, julienne, half a jicama.
Nice.
Okay. And now I'm tossing with this.
Should we add a little bit of that?
Yeah, add a little bit of that.
Just too much?
I think that's enough. 2 tablespoons of dressing. And then...
Oh, it looks really nice on that black plate. Lots of contrast.
Yeah.
And then the pomelo, does it get tossed with the dressing at all, or just?
Yeah. Usually, I'll toss with the dressing.
It's so pretty.
Yeah, very pretty color. And
Do you have pomelo in Vietnam?
We do have a lot in Vietnam. There's so many types of pomelo, not only one kind, like in America.
Very nice.
Yeah. And I will put a few of candy walnut.
Oh, those look delicious.
On the top. So I put a few on the side or on the top.
Nice.
There you go.
I have to try one walnut.
Yeah.
Tastes exactly like I hoped it would. Sophie, this is just beautiful. How do you say thank you in Vietnamese?
Cảm ơn.
Cảm ơn. Thank you very much. And we'll be right back with Sophie's brother, Eric Banh, and another Vietnamese dish. I'm so happy to be behind the line with Eric Banh here at Monsoon. And Eric, you're gonna make a dish called venison sao lan.
That's a really good pronunciation, Greg.
Ganom. Ganom.
Yes.
Anyway, it's a dish that looks like the mise en place is very important, the preparation in advance, right?
Getting mise en place exists everywhere. And by the way, what exactly is mise en place?
It's a French word that means arrangement of the area. Like in movies, you have mise en scene, in the kitchen, you have mise en place. So mise en place in the kitchen is what you do every day, getting everything ready to go. And this, Eric, is something I'm not familiar with. It's can you tell me about these ingredients?
Absolutely, Greg. These are fresh wood ear mushrooms you don't normally see in a lot of restaurants in Seattle.
And then this is a mung bean?
They call it glass noodles, or mung beans noodles. And you can buy them at the various Asian grocery market, Vikwa or Wartemeyer, and you can soak it in lukewarm water for about 2 hours or so.
Yeah, I'm eager to learn how to use those. And this herb is one that we don't see much in America.
Without this herb, this dish would not have the aroma that we use. In Vietnamese, we call it ngò om, and we even use it in tamarind soup as well.
Oh, that would be a good combination.
Yes, absolutely.
So show me a little bit how you got this mise en place. If we just show me how you get that super fine cut on the lemongrass, then I'm eager to see how this dish comes together.
Make sure you get rid of the root.
That part's very tough,
That part is really tough. And at the same time, you cut it, the top part, because these are very grassy and doesn't have that much flavor. What you want is, you have to slice them finely first. You cannot throw this in the food processor or restaurant. We use this instrument called RoboCube because the texture is so tough.
And it would just spin around.
It just spin and then end up you have a lot of hairy,
like a mouthful
texture.
Of fibers.
And now you just finally chop them. Lemongrass, you can buy them at Safeway, QFC. I see them everywhere.
Yeah, I do see it everywhere now. But it's so aromatic. I imagine that what we're smelling is escaping. So if it were dried, all that good flavor that we smell now is already gone.
Absolutely.
So in addition to this lemongrass, it looks like you have shallots, some garlic, some red chilies in oil, and this curry powder. I'm curious, looks a little bit different than the traditional Indian curry powder.
I brought back some curry powders from Singapore as well as Sri Lanka.
So I guess the only ingredient left to explore here is the venison itself.
You can interchange this flavor with beef as well. Traditionally in Vietnam, we do with three game meat, and I don't know if you call frog legs game meat.
Well, yeah, I guess so.
Wild boar,
any kind of
venison,
wild meat, huh?
And frog legs are known for this flavor. Make sure you slice them thinly because we're working with a wok, which is sauteing, and you don't want to.
So small pieces,
thinly sliced, and make sure you cut against the grain. That way, it will reduce the toughness of the meat.
Oh, I can that will be very tender because the grains are separating even as
these
you slice.
These are incredibly soft meat. It's so much softer than even beef tenderloin. So if you can find them, I think they will be becoming more popular as people realize this is lower fat content than beef. You can prepare this ahead overnight. And my philosophy is I don't like to marinate any protein in this restaurant. The true flavor is so wonderful, you don't need to marinate anything at all.
Great. Well, let's cook it.
Let's do it. All right, Greg. I want to warm up the wok a little bit and then just put two tablespoons of peanut oil. You can use vegetable oil will be fine, and some shallot, lemongrass, and I say 3 tablespoons. You see, that's the flavor, and I'm going to throw in the venison. I'll throw in a little bit of salt in there. And now I'm going to throw in garlic because I want to prevent the burning of the garlic at the beginning stage. Chili oil that I use. And then I'm going to sweat it a little bit, steam it a little bit with the veal stock that we have right here. then half tablespoons of fish sauce,
and there's the curry.
Curry powder, absolutely. Now the meat is almost ready, and I'm going to throw in about a cup of wood ear mushroom.
Those amazing fresh wood ears.
Along with 1 cup of
glass noodle.
Glass noodle, or call it mung beans noodle. And this, the coconut is almost a binding of everything together. The French, I would say, if you even use wine, just we instead of using wine, this is what we do. And we are done, Greg. I will plate it right here for you.
Isn't that wonderful? And the smell.
I'm gonna put the ma'om on there along with peanuts. It's very important.
Oh, we forgot the garnish.
Yeah. No, that's, and roasted peanuts. Now we are done.
Well, I thank you again. This has been a real pleasure.
Thank you, Greg.
Thank you.